with you.
Yeah.
So what's happening here?
Well, I'm just taking you through some of the features of the brand new Land Rover Defender. Of course, now this is a car that has been rebuilt for the millennial age. It's basically what, in my opinion, they're doing here is they have thought about, we're in 2020, blank slate. If you are to come up with the best off-road capable vehicle in the world using the manufacturing techniques we have available now, using the materials we have available now, using the technology we have available now, this is it. This is basically like a schoolboy's wish list of everything that you could do to make a car amazing at going off-road. This is it. So just giving Moses over here some of the many features that are available here, including some of the really cool ones.
So let's start with the rear view mirror. Let's start with that one.
Okay, so this is called the clear sight rear view mirror. So as you can see now, basically, just like in a traditional mirror, there's a lot of stuff in the background. There's the headrests for the guys in the back. If there were actually guys sitting in the back, you know, you'd see the heads over here. And then one of the iconic design things of the Defender is that the spare tire is mounted on the rear windshield.
Yeah.
So usually, this is what you'd be seeing and you'd be struggling to see out of the rear view mirror. But what they've done is they put a camera in the top of the roof and all you do is just flip this. Wow. And all of a sudden, you're just seeing a view from the camera. And then to top this off, this is actually a low light camera. So you actually see better at night than you would with a normal camera, with a normal mirror. And you don't get glare from reflections, from guys behind you. So it's just one of the things that they have done. Like you can see here, all of the tech in this car is there for a purpose. It's not there for marketing, you know, just for cool stuff to tell people about. It's there because it needs to be there and for no reason other than that.
What about this center console? You were showing me something really cool earlier.
Oh, yeah. So the clear view system, now the camera system, also extends to the car itself. So what we are seeing here is augmented reality. So you're getting feeds from all four cameras around the car. And then they superimpose a 3D model of the vehicle in the physical space around it. So basically, if you're driving off-road, you wouldn't need to get out of the car to see what the obstacles around the car would be. You can do that from inside the car. Or if you're a 21st century adventurer and you're, you know, operating the urban jungle of the streets of Nairobi, this is also really good for parking. Yeah, so you don't necessarily need to be going off-road, even on tarmac. This is also spectacular. So you can see a lot of stuff is dual use, like here. Can I actually take you through this? So all of the controls that are usually on the gearbox cluster here have been shifted up because this entire area can be used as a jump seat. So you can actually add a seat in between here.
Mm-hmm.
And so what they've done here is that there's a whole lot of buttons that are available. So what you're seeing initially now is the dual zone AC, temperature control. So this is the temperature for your side, the driver. This is the temperature for the passenger side. But with the touch of a button, all of a sudden now this has changed and now this is doing the fan speed. Yeah. Or, because this, of course, now is a Land Rover, if I press this, this dial now selects the terrain response system now, which is the whole big deal about a Land Rover. So now these are the different off-road modes that the car is doing. So eco for saving fuel. Then, of course, now you have comfort for everyday stuff. Then you have grass, gravel, and snow. So this is when you're driving on a solid surface that has something sticky on top, mm-hmm. or slippery. And then the next one, of course, now is mud and rats. And then sand, and then rock crawl. And then new for the Defender is the wading setting. So this is to help you wade through water. Defender has the highest wading depth of any manufactured car in the world currently. Like this is 900, it can wade through 900 millimeters of water, which is higher than anything. Land Cruiser, Jeep, anything stock out of the factory. Anything else, you'd have to now modify the car. So this is just coming straight out of the factory like that. And then, in addition to that, it has wade sensing. So in each of the rear view mirrors, they actually sonar sensors that ping down and it'll tell you how deep the water is while you're driving through there. So it's all about, like, the technology is there to help you. It's not for fun times. Then, of course, now we've not set up one of the settings, but since you're talking technology and you're a technology guy, you actually also can customize these terrain response. There's one that you can customize yourself. You can pick and choose what it is that you want. You can do with other Land Rover products. But what I need to show you here is you see this is something very familiar. You actually get notifications. The car is connected with 4G. So you actually can...
The actual car?
The car, yeah. So you can either insert a SIM card and then have the car have access to the internet. or the car can connect to a hotspot. So either you can get to Wi-Fi in your house, or you can create a hotspot with your phone. This is getting over the air updates. So this is a new system, it's called PV Pro. Now, in addition to that, it actually has individual user profiles, which we haven't set up since this is not my car. And guess what, Moses, they use machine learning to figure out your patterns, and then it adjusts based on you.
No way.
So like what happens is, depending on either the key you're using, because you can either have, of course, you can have multiple keys. So maybe you'd have one for you or one for your wife,
mm-hmm.
or the phone that you connect to the system,
yeah.
it will learn your personal habits. So like you, Moses, it will figure out that in the morning, you usually drive from home to the office every day, Monday to Friday, between like 7 or something. So what it will do is that after it figures that out, the inbuilt navigation, when you get into the car in the morning, will automatically set your office location as the location over time. Because just like what Google does with an office.
Yeah.
In addition to that, it will also remember the station that you listen to in the morning. Might be different from what you listen to in the evening. So in the evening, when you get into the car, it will be on that station.
Okay.
In addition to that, it will figure out how you like your settings based on exterior, you know, inputs. So like if you like to heat, because you know these seats are also heated and cooled. I've not actually finished with this. If you push this, it actually opens the settings for your heated and cooled seats. So let me just start the car. Yeah. So
oh wow okay guys, I'm moving.
So those are usually when you come into the car, usually have like, you see those buttons over there in the numbers, usually it's your seat setting.
Okay,
now what Defender is doing is, in addition to remembering your seat settings, and of course now the settings for the safety belt, like I was saying, it will use machine learning to figure out your navigation, where are you going,
who
do you call on a regular basis, what temperature do you like it inside the car when it's raining, so that every time it rains it does that. It will figure out what speed settings you like. Like basically it learns you, and then it now provides all that information on the screen, or it changes the settings to match you or anybody else using the car. So you'd have a different driving pattern from, let's say, your partner. So she connects her phone, everything now matches to her. So like the temperature in the car, how she likes the car when it's raining.
So all those variables.
Yeah, all the variables. Like the temperature inside the car, how do you like your seat setup? How do you like the seat heating, seat cooling? All that stuff. So the car is going to, it learns you and it gets better over time, because it's also getting over the air updates, just like you did on your iPhone with iOS 14. So like once you get this, just unlike, because one of the things that people don't like about technologies in cars is that it's fixed. It doesn't change over time.
Yeah.
You want the new version, you have to buy the new car. This is getting over the updates like a Tesla, so it will improve over time.
Great, thanks so much, Mwirigi. That's awesome. Yeah, cool. I appreciate it. I know this is very impromptu, but wow, this is an awesome car. So, guys, that's a Land Rover Defender. I completely stumbled into Mwirigi somewhere, and I just couldn't resist the opportunity to create this little video. So, I hope you get some value out of it. And Mwirigi, asante sana.
Cool.